All right, guys, we are entering King's Row, and oh, actually, you know, I apologize, guys. I did not take care of this before the other one. Yes, there we go. All right, we are not using stopwatch, so that is not relevant. Again, guys, thank you so much for stopping by. This is the Superstar League EU kickoff tournament. This is their first tournament, an organized event that they are doing as an organizer. So again, special shout out to them and thank you. Please give them a follow, and we'll get right into this next match. As again, the last one was pretty exciting. Unfortunately, I can't leave the doors until the match has started, and we will go ahead and get into the actual map as I will switch over here to the defense and be doing introductions in just a second, guys. Again, this is King's Row. This is a best of one, but if both teams score, we will be moving into a random King of the Hill, one of the three King of the Hill maps, a random one of the three of those three, and decide the map based on that. But without further ado, I will go ahead and make sure I got the teams right, and it looks like I do have them right, as we have... Oh, I'm really bad at Russian, guys, so please forgive me. Sasek Minut Buzhka, or I'll just call them the blue team from now on, as I'm going to try that once and never again. We have Fnatic going to be picking up the Widowmaker, Cubax is going to be picking up the Symmetra, Jazio is going to be picking up a Reinhardt. We have a McCree for... Corazon, Emis, however you want to pronounce that, or give me a phonetic, that'd be very helpful, is going to be picking up a Mercy, and that leaves a Junkrat for Godorcio. On the side of the offense for Serious Intentions, we have Bernie going to be on a Winston, another tank for Spear on a Reinhardt. We have Silence on the offensive Widow. Pick's already going to happen, already does tag up the defensive window. That leaves Shenji on a Mercy. Constable is going to be picking up the second support as a Lucio, and that leaves Fragum as the last player for the side of the offensive frag. Fnatic, it's a kill. Spear goes down. We'll get right into the action, guys. We're done with the player introductions. The action's already begun. Two down on the side of the offense already, as you can see that that defensive Widow is already paying I'm sorry, guys, I'm messing up the production here. You can see that the defensive Widow is already paying itself off, doing quite a bit here. We'll go ahead and get an overview view. You can see the sentries are set up and spread out nicely, so it's very hard for them to destroy. Offensive Widow going to be looking for the picks. Fnatic is looking to get those his own shots on the offensive Widow, and Spear, he gets stunned up, takes quite a bit of damage. Silence goes down. Fnatic is on fire. We're just going to go ahead and switch to him, guys. Right now, this is critical. These picks that he's getting is stalling up the offense's momentum big time. And he picks up Frag. Oh no, if he gets the second kill, Silence, Fnatic is just feeling it right now, guys. I really got to say, this Widow right now has hit a very good feeling right now. And there we go, cause I'm going to push forward with the triple kill Deadeye. Timed out with the charge. That's a team kill. And this is not looking good for Sasek, as unfortunately, if you're a fan of them, Serious Intention is playing incredibly strong. Fnatic on the low ground with the Widow, not even using that high ground advantage, is going to be once again entering into this duel with Silence. Note how he has the Mercy charge and he gets the headshot regardless. Doesn't even need the damage amp from the Mercy. Is able to secure that kill. And wow. It's Polish? Okay, I apologize again, guys. I'm sorry. I'm an ignorant American. I'm trying to do my best with this. I apologize. Helping me with that is exactly what I do need to get it correct. And Corazon does go down. Kubak's going to be going down as well. We have Bernie switching into that Primal Rage. We're going to switch away from him. Decently hard to follow. Jazio is going to go down as he's taking quite a bit of damage from Silence. Silence is going to go down himself. No, he's just taking a fair bit of damage. Takes out the Mercy. That's two down on the side of the defense. Kubix is trying to defend his teleporter. Will defend it, so the reinforcement should be pretty quick. And it seems like they're going to be able to clean up the offense again. Senji does have that resurrection, but we'll see if he can get it off. Does it look like he wants to use it? They're going to go ahead and hold it. Multiple ultimates on the side of the offense. Earth Shatter, Sound Barrier, and Resurrection. Defense going to be sitting on almost two. They have a Deadeye and they almost have an Infrasight. So they do have a fair bit on their side. But we're going to go ahead and push forward with follow out. Senji here is a Nevermind. Corazon going to go down. Frag, I'm picking up multiple. We need to switch to him as he's critical here for the offense as he's doing what he can. Looking to get that Symmetra. Make it 3-4 going down on the side of the defense. This might be the momentum the offense needed. They are going to get the first tick of the control point charge in from Jazz as he's going to try to stall it up best he can. No flashbang available for McCree. Just came up. Does use it, but it's too late. Again, teleporter is available, but if the defense gets into a spawn tramp where they're sending multiple players one by one by one or in groups of pockets of resistance, then they can get killed, have only four up, two more die, only four up, two more die, only four up, and that's what we call a spawn trap on the side of the defense. So you want to be careful with that teleporter. We'll go ahead and switch here to Fnatic, as again, he was the one who looked or opened up the side of the defense for... At the beginning of the map, but Silence getting in very deep. Gonna actually damage up Fnatic. Normally, you look for the Widow there to get the kill on Silence and be able to take him out, but Silence playing a very strong Pharah here, using the map and his mobility to his advantage, but he is going to take quite a bit from that fan. Does end up avoiding. He hasn't used that concussive rocket. He still has it on cooldown to go ahead and clear distance. But we're going to move into the streets phase, guys. Again, this is not stopwatch. If one team converts and the other team doesn't, then that is the end of the match. If both teams convert, we'll go to a random King of the Hill decider. Sound barrier coming out from the side of the defense, but it's not doing that much. Push out from Corazon is going to be using that Deadeye, but it doesn't get as much as well. But that, again, Silence. Great understanding of the map. Going to be flanking in, but his team getting cleaned up there. Corazon going off himself on this McCree. That Deadeye, the Urshatter didn't look like it canceled it. It looks like he got it off, got out multiple kills. And this is the kind of defensive stall that you need. One thing I want to note here real quick is I'll go ahead and switch to overhead view, guys. One thing you want to try to do on the defense is set up right here around this corner. Note how they actually have this corner to set up the defense. The offense has to run into this corridor. They have to use the left and right side, but the offense is just going to go ahead and pressure in. They're going to go straight in. Spearheading the charge, for lack of a better term, is going to get charged at by Jazz, but Jazz doesn't end up pinning him. Silence. Two of his teammates, one of his teammates going down, Spear getting low, Fnatic going to be picking up a kill. That's on Fraga, multiple down already on the side of the offense. They should only have two, but Silence gets picked off as well. And again, Fnatic, right now, he's my MVP for the side of the defense. Going off, Jazz going to be picking up another kill. God, picking up a fifth, as it looks like multiple are just going to be going down on the side of the offense. Urshatter came out from Jazz as he's just swinging away. Does take out Bernie, and this is going to be another stalled up offense on the side of Szek. If you're a fan of them and you're a Polish Overwatch, give them some dongers in the chat. Give them some praise. Give them some coppas. Give them anything you can, guys. They need some praise. They need some support here as they need to get an offense going. Fragum gonna get picked up inside of the hotel, and that's not what you want at all if you're on the offense. This charge, this could be critical. If Bernie goes down, they're gonna be eating up another 30 seconds. Immediately, Bernie pops that Primal Rage. Jazz does barely survive. If the Winston can get in here and kill him, that would be huge. They do have a resurrection on the side of Kermes, but or Emmys, but they're probably not gonna want to use it right here. Left clicks, going out, trying to do what they can. And I apologize, I meant to say the side of Serious Intentions. If you're a fan of them, they need your help. They need your support in the chat right now. Silence actually going to be answering right now as he gets a kill. Make it possibly two as he's hunting in. Constable is going to go down. It looks like Silence is going to be doing that good job on Pharah. Flanking around Rocket Barrage. Will it be enough? Does he get Mercy? He does. That's two. This is what his team needs. Concussive Rocket going to be pushing back, but he's lost multiple teammates. Sinju is down. Bernie is down. Will Fragum be able to answer? Spear Fragum answering. Looks like multiple down on the side of the defense. That's five total, only one in the area to defend. And that's a team... No, that wasn't a team kill horn, I believe. That was just to capture the point. And it looks like Szek is going to have a bit more to chew than they thought. As the Serious Intentions comes back and answered after a minute and a half, almost 2 minutes of straight, getting stalled out. But the defense still has an entire section to hold. And again, this is not stopwatch. So it is critical that the team gets a full hold. Or that they, at this point, they have to hold at this point, right? They have to hold, and it just comes down to whether or not the offense can score or not on the next point. But we'll get to that as the action is going to be breaking out. A better flashbang coming out from Corazon, takes out Frag. And Serious Intentions getting stalled up here on their first attempt on the Foundry part of the offense. Silence going down, 3, 4, 5 down total. Oh, Corazon, he rolls off. That's not what you want to see. But I don't think it's honestly going to matter too much, guys. As Bernie goes down, we shouldn't have a team kill horn. But that's going to be the offense getting cleaned up. They have 2.5 minutes to get something going here. Look for them to group up. Look for them to set up as a team before they go in. They need to try to get a clean initiation. Four ultimates up on the side of the offense. Three on the side of the defense. Deadeye a pair for both sides. Resurrection of Pharah for both sides. We have a Riptire and a Sound Barrier for the offense. And a Sound Barrier and an Earthshatter for the side of the offense. And a Riptire for the side of the defense. And it looks like we are going to be having that TAC Visor coming inside. And there's the Sound Barrier coming up. Looks like the Earthshatter does get absorbed by the barrier. That's not good. Riptire going out, hunting down on the Lucio. 4, 5 down on the side of the defense. Emmys does get the Resurrection, but it doesn't look like it's going to do that much. There's the offensive Resurrection as Bernie's trying to go off. Do what he can. Fnatic pops that TAC Visor, going down to Silence though, as the Jazz dies mid-Earthshatter. He still has it in his back pocket, but the offense, Fragum with that Deadeye, is he gonna get two? He does, he gets two, three. Silence picking up one himself, and it looks like Serious Intentions is going to convert here with a minute 50 seconds left on the clock. They don't get the flashbang on Fnatic, but he rushes out, he ends up dying 3 meters away, 1 meter away. Will they be able to score it before the charge? They do. Serious Intention scores with 1 minute and 45 seconds left. And guys, again, this just comes down to whether or not the other team scores now. If they fail to score at all, then it will be a point awarded to Serious Intentions. They will move on then in the winner's bracket. And if they both score, we'll go to the King of the Hill, a random map, not a best of three, just a random map as a decider. Silence. I gotta say, he looked a little iffy there at the beginning on his Pharah, but man, he really, really, really played a strong Pharah after that. If you're looking to pick up Pharah yourself, I highly recommend you look at what he was doing well in that Pharah game. Of course, there's things that you can gripe at, things you can get on. There always is. No player is ever perfect, but the things he did well that you can emulate in your own play is he was using the sides of the map. He was consistently using his boosters and then fluttering with his hover jet and exploiting the angles of the map, the verticality of the map, flanking consistently. And while you would think that a Widow is a hard counter to Pharah, and it is, I don't want you to at all think that Widow doesn't hard counter Pharah, because she does, but a intelligent Pharah using the edges of the map that is able to access and control them more than the Widow's team is able to consistently flank and dominate the Widow by getting two clean rockets, one of which usually comes out as a direct rocket because of the flank. So that's kind of what I just want to harp on there, guys. And we'll be getting into the second game in just a second here, as again, we have Sesek Minute Bujaka versus Serious Intentions. I should really stop trying to say that, but I want to get better at it so I can do better in future events for you guys, as it does honestly matter, in my opinion, that I'm able to pronounce these team names. So without further ado, we'll go ahead and get into the next game, guys, in just a second.
My ultimate is charging.
Thank you.
Oh no, guys, I greatly apologize. I am so sorry. I am so sorry. Fixed in 60 seconds. That is just a big goof from me, guys, and I am so sorry. There's no excuse there. I'm going to just go ahead and move past it, as I shouldn't dwell on it, but I apologize. Big mistake from me. Great offense here in the streets phase. Coming out from the side of the Polish team. I won't make that mistake again. Corazon going to be looking to get that Deadeye. Does get two going down, and it looks like going to be taking out another one. No, the fan, the hammer doesn't get it, but he does take out Fragum. 3-4 going down on the side of the defense, and it looks like Serious Intentions is going to have a trouble holding here. They need to stabilize. Bernie going down, and oh no, Silence fell off. Silence fell off, guys. He fell off the cliff, as you can just see the skull or the kill in the top left, and it looks like it's going to be a problem here for the side of Serious Intentions, Serious Intentions. They need to hold here. If you're a fan of them, guys, please give them some chat. Give them some hype. It's going to come down to their defense in the last 50 seconds here, or last 5 minutes. Corazon going to push in. Kubek's getting a kill. Fragum, Constable answering. But no, Corazon taking out Silence. Resurrection from Emmy. He's going to bring up his team as they look to be able to look to take out Fragum. He almost rolls off the cliff. Left click coming out from Corazon, trying to pick him off. Guys, Frag, it's incredible important that he gets this kill here. No, Corazon takes him out. We might have the end of the game there, guys. We might have the end of the game here as they're pushing in. Serious Intentions down. Only 3 remaining. Silence goes down. Deadeye coming out from, again, the offense. That's Fnatic, and it looks like they're going to score it, guys, as the side of Serious Intentions does go ahead and get scored on. We should move to a King of the Hill. Best of one deciders. Both teams were able to score. And I'll go ahead and say it one more time, guys. I am so sorry. I apologize for that. Should be fixed on stream in 10 seconds or so. Sorry again. Major, major mistake. I apologize, guys. There's really not much else to say there. I don't want to dwell on it, but I want to express to you guys that I will double check that again. That is not something that I should be letting happen. And so I apologize. Again, both teams scored, so we will be moving to a King of the Hill best of cider. Yeah. Only be a one on it. Not stopwatch, so it will be King of the Hill. I apologize, guys. Oof. Really need to not dwell on it, but you know how the nerves go. Make those mistakes. You just like keeps eating at you, you know, fills your head and stuff like that. But the key to it is just to move on. I am not sure what of the three. King of the Hill. Alright, looks like it's a best of three decider, guys. And I am figuring this out as I go. Unfortunately, some of these rules were figured out. Alright, well, if that's the ruling. I would say one team choose. I don't know how to do random. Either do O draft or do RNG or com 1-3 for the 3 King of the Hill. That's up to you guys. Just be civil and Alright guys, let me set up the RNG real quick. I need to set up a screen capture. Random number generator. Random generator. We need 1 through 3. We need to move this here. We need to do a quick screen cap. Add monitor capture. Add window capture. Okay. Alright, so I'll go ahead and do this. It'll be on stream. It will be delayed 90 seconds, so I will update the teams about that. We're randomly generating, and 1 was the thing. I'll go ahead and leave it here just for a second, guys, so you can confirm everyone's happy. We'll go ahead and remove it. So 1, it's 90 sec delay, but rng.org says 1. We are going to the show. If you want to confirm, it will show. Okay, guys, so sorry about that. I am trying to have to admin on this as well. The rules, something that definitely future events for this. I know Mythic is definitely listening to you guys, and I know he's definitely hearing your feedback. This is the first time they're running this tournament, first time they're doing it, so it will be, not to say, you know, strictly 100% choppy and all that stuff. Like, of course, yes, but more so, what do I want to say? Like, yeah, he's listening. So if the competitive, if you guys as the players really want Stopwatch for the next event, please go ahead and like say that to him, private message him on Discord, let him know. At the end of the day, tournaments matter to the players and to the fans. And so as long as both are happy, then that's what matters. Again, this is the first iteration of it. So I am good to go on TV. So, yeah, thank you so much, guys, again, for watching. Please follow below, and one more time, I'll leave it there. I apologize for muting my mic. I will try to keep that double-checked. I need to make a sticky note and just put it on my computer so it's right there in front of me, so I always know. And, we'll go ahead and get into this match, guys, as once the teams are decided for which color they are, we'll update. We are entering the game, loading it up, and we have Lijong Tower. Going to be played out here. And let me make sure I got the teams right, as it looks like it might just be right. It might just be... No, it is not right. It is not right? No, it is not right. No, it is right. It is right. Okay. Yeah, if it's wrong, guys, please let me know. Thank you. Thank you very much, Fever James. I really appreciate that. I'm a brand new caster guy. Well, I did cast Dota 2 for a little while, but like I am definitely a new caster to Overwatch. I'm figuring it out. I apologize for all the mistakes. I apologize for any production errors and stuff like that. I'm trying to get this down to an art, to a formula. It's a little bit harder than anticipated. But on the side of, if I have the overlays right, and I'm pretty sure I do, it is in Serious Intentions. We have no, it's not. I knew it was wrong. I'm sorry, guys. Gut instinct there, and I knew it was wrong. We have the Polish team going to be picking up a McCree with Corazon. We have Emmy's going to be picking up the Mercy. Fnatic are going to be on a Soldier. Gordosio going to be picking up the Zarya. Kubix on the Lucio, which leaves Jazz on the Winston. I won't be able to get the other introductions done by the time the game starts, guys, so we'll go ahead and get straight into the action here as we already have the fights breaking out. Both teams looking to conflict over the point. Right side. Pharah firing in the rockets. Look in the center of the fight. We have the Winston and the McCree going at it. No kills yet. Just damage going out. And we'll go ahead and switch to the actual fights with Fnatic. Gonna be taking out Bernie there. It's hard to follow all of this action at once, guys. Jed Spear gonna be going down. He's not gonna go down. He's barely surviving. Kubix goes down. Jazz is able to take him out. And it looks like with the kill on Spear, they're gonna lose Senji as well right after that. And it looks like with that, Silence is probably going to go down in just a second. So again, guys, really quickly, introductions. On the other side, we have Kostopol picking up a Mercy. We have Sinji picking up a Lucio. Silence on a Pharah. We have Fragum on the McCree. Bernie going to be picking up a Winston. And that finally leaves Spear on that Zarya. Like we were saying earlier, Rocket Spam going out. Gardusio taking quite a bit of damage here. Fragum trying to sled up on the left-hand sides. Getting that left click out. He's gone ahead and farmed up a Deadeye already. Look for him to be using that and getting critical kills. And I just had to freak out that the mic was muted again. Oh, it's going to haunt me all day. Frag him. Looking for those kills. Oh, no. That's a Graviton Surge we heard, guys. That's a Graviton Surge. It's catch on. 2, 3. Actually, not doing enough, though. There's really no capitalization on it. And now we have multiple fights going out, but the skirmishes are not really turning into much. Fragum gets a kill on Jazz. Fragum going low himself. Will he be able to survive? We'll be able to see in just a second as he's looking to fight out here. Gets that health pack. Left click's going out. Will go onto the Zarya. Rolls back. Reloads his gun. Trying to get God, but not enough. Does get him. And Silence is going to go down as well. Korzem taking him out. 1-for-1 trade on both sides. And he's looking to get that Resurrection. Already one down. Resurrection coming out for the side of Serious Intentions. Constant Double goes down right after it. Emmys, will he go down after he uses his Resurrection? That tends to be what happens. 2 are down on the side of the blue side, 1 down on the side of the red. And now Corazon looking for that Deadeye. They're all hiding. Oh no, he peeked out. Senji goes down, but the rocket from Silence picks him up. That's a critical kill. Now Justice raining from above. 2, 3 kills Silence. Will he make it 4? Not quite a quad, definitely a triple, but he will pick up a total of 4 kills. That's absolutely huge from Serious Intentions. And, wow. What a game so far from Silence. I gotta say, his fair play is really something to definitely take a look out for and be aware of. I think that, while I agree with a Tracer on King of the Hill in general, I think they better stick to a McCree and a Soldier to deal with this fair, but Kubak's gonna go down. Definitely a Fragum going off there with his Deadeye. I'm sorry we missed that. He's getting multiple kills. We'll go ahead and switch to Spear here as he's at a 94 charge. Those lobs now doing a total of 92 damage at 100% charge. His left click doing 160 damage per second, immediately nuking down that Tracer. And like I said, I'd really like to see a McCree here instead to help deal with that fair. They need the long range hit scan, in my opinion. And Spear, again, spamming out 1% damage for every percent of the charge. We'll go ahead and switch over to here for Fnatic as he needs to get some kills here. He's going down to 1 HP. Will he survive? He will. Oh, that would have been so bad if he went down. They're going to be losing a lot of time on the point here. There's the Tacfizer Fragum going down. Will they be able to get back control of the point here? Graviton Surge coming out with a Rocket Barrage. Spear getting 2 of those kills, but the Resurrection resetting it. And that's exactly what you need out of your Mercy play. Emmy's going huge there. Another Graviton Surge going out, catching 2. They're walking into it. Now 3. Now 4. Corazon with the Pulse Bomb. But the Resurrection again resetting the fight. Both Mercies going off here. Sound Barriers. And both teams fighting it out. Duking it out. Spear picking up Fnatic. After Fnatic picks up Constantinople, Karzan picking up Bernie will follow him out as he's trying to do what he can to control the fight for his team. Deadeye coming out. That's Fragum. But he goes down. Does get Corazon before he goes down at the end. Silence again still alive on that Pharah, doing what he can, but the point is contested, and the side of Serious Intentions does have the point, so they're gaining more time. They're at 99%. If they ever get the Rocket Barrage, will it get enough kills here? No, it's not going to do anything. He goes down in the middle of it. Fragum, now it's up to him and squad. Silence going down, no Resurrection in the near term. The Polish team does have multiple heroes out of Graviton Surge. Graviton Surge catching on multiple. That's huge, but Fragum wasn't able to capitalize on it. Only 2 go down in the middle of it. Resurrection coming out from the side of Constantinople, trying to setting up Emmys. Does have his own Resurrection, uses it, resets his team. Running away, trying to get away from that Winston. Jazz trying to pick off. Fragum trying to pick off Jazz, does get him. Now looking for that Tracer, as picking her off would be critical to stop the contention. It does, only 2 down. Sound Barrier going out for the side of the blue team. As guys, I'm apologize, this is just hectic. So much action going everywhere. Fnatic dropping that Biotic Field, taking a fan the hammer. Graviton Surge on 4. Is this what they need to get back the point? Is this what they need? Jazz gets 2, Fnatic gets 1. I don't know if it's going to be enough. Silence dropping super low himself. I don't know. Silence looking to do what he can. He's still alive. Rocket Barrage goes out, but no. Cubics at the back. Or Corazon in the back. Flanks him. Takes him out. It's any second now. 1 point. Now they take it. 72%. Overtime reset. And the side of the Polish Overwatch team is going to be able to stabilize here. Get back on the point. 75%. 79%. Fragum with the high noon. Does take out the Tracer. That's critical. We're going to go switch over to him as he's being chased down by Winston. Taking huge damage from the Tesla Cannon. Jazz able to clean him up. And again, Spear, low health, trying to get back control of this point. Guys, this is just absolutely hectic. It's absolutely hectic. Silence again on this flank. Look for him to look for that Soldier. Again, he can't worry. He has to worry about the Soldier when he goes into the air. There's a Graviton Surge. They have been absolutely critical, changing the outcome of these fight. 3 down. Blue team wipe. Overtime. No, Polish Overwatch team of Shizek is going to be able to take the first point. Good half. We'll go into the second iteration of Yizhong Control Tower. And guys, This is an absolutely crazy match. I'm going to take a quick break, get some, drink some water, and we'll get right into the next match. Thank you so much for watching. Thank you so much for tuning out. This is the Superstar League. First, EU Overwatch tournament kickoff. Thank you so much for watching. I am Raptors OW, and I'm so glad to be bringing you guys these matches. All right, well, I pressed the button, but I didn't actually mute it, so apologize for you guys hearing me glurg my water there, coming out of my water bottle, but I do need to keep voice hydrated. Sides are going to be staying the same, as we have the Polish team doing what they can. Doing what they can to close it out. If they can close out 2-0, that would be good. You never really want to play a third game. I mean, that's an obvious statement, but, like, when you're on the side of a competitive team, it's something you're talking about in between games because you want to have as few games as possible to that winning position. And we'll go ahead and switch the overhead view here, guys. Apologize as I'm getting used to controlling this camera. We have all the blue team grouped over here to the right side of the camera. Left side is going to be the red team as they're set up on the outside. Usually you want to be on the inside to avoid getting bopped off by a Lucio, but the outside does offer more angles to cover yourselves up and have better peaks. Looks like both Winstons duking it out. Jazz with the shield still up, and the blue team is going to assert themselves and be able to get control of the point first, as we do have the Pharah coming out. Silence, he was already able to farm up a rocket barrage. He gets it off, does quite a bit. Resurrection goes off, tries to stabilize, does get up multiple frag in the background, trying to keep his team in this fight. High Noon coming out, doesn't do that much. Pulse Bomb as well coming out from Corazon. Again, it's not doing that much. Crudstopple is going to go down. Corazon on this Tracer. More coming out of his left clicks. Then coming out of his pulse bomb as he's looking to take out Fragum. Good job there, dodging. I mean, he doesn't really dodge the fan of the hammer. He just spams the rewind button and does get it off at the last second. Going to be able to clean it up. That wasn't quite a team kill, but they are going to be in control of the point here, and that's going to be 37% already ticking down. You gotta control yourself here with serious intentions. This is where it comes down to the meat of your team. If you're going to be a successful competitive team, you need to rally together, hold strong, maintain good communications, maintain good crossfires, maintain good fundamentals, despite being down, despite being 50% away from being knocked into the loser's bracket. So look for them to do that pulse bomb going out. Does pick up Jazz. That's not what you want to see. And High Noon coming out. Oh, Graviton Surge pulls in two. Fragum able to get two of those, but the Resurrection from the side of Emmy is going to help pick up his team. And now his entire team is up except for Cubix. Oh, close out of the Resurrection. Oh, another Tobalstein. We should be switching to that. Two going down. Corazon picks him up. Corazon getting multiple kills off of that. Spearum getting another one. Jazu, another one. Immies and team cleaning it up as they're still on the point. 78%. Wow. Again, the Polish Overwatch team coming out so strong here on this King of the Hill map. The first map was much closer, but right now, you gotta hand it to the Polish side. They're doing what they're supposed to. They're controlling it the way they need to. So we'll switch to Silence because we want them to win. We want them to go to a game three, guys. We want more games. It's always good to watch them. No! Flying off the edge. If you're a fan of the Polish side, that's not what you want to see. But if you're a side or a fan of Serious Intentions, they need this. 99%. Contest has become overtime. There's the rocket barrage. He's going to be taking out the McCree. Does take out Emmy, so no resurrection. If they can flip the point here, it's going to be critical. But Senji's is one of the few supports left on the point, as they did lose Kutsopel, as he's going to have the resurrection, having to run back. Senji goes down. Silence was taken out. Fragum's outside of the point. The only one on the point, I believe, is Bernie, as he's going to be fighting out. He doesn't have a primal rage, so if he goes down here, that'll be it. Two on the point. It looks like they're going to be able to flip it. And no, contesting coming out from the blue side, but Fnatic goes down, taking a lot of damage. Emmy's going to get the resurrection, does go down right before Graviton Surge coming out. Bernie picking up three, picking up four. Total on the side of the offense, on the side of the red team. They're going to be able to maybe get back control at this point. There's three contesting. They want to get this. Fragum trying to hold it out, but Silence and him are answering. Still, only one down on the side of the blue team. This is becoming down to the last second. Last second, as they're not able to control the point. If they can't get a flip here, guys, it'll just take the wipe of this for them to get Polish Overwatch, the side of Zizek, to win this match. We're switching over to Silence. We're switching over to Bernie. They have to stay alive. They have to win here, guys. If they don't stay alive, if they don't get onto the point, it will be okay. They flip. They flip the point, guys. They flip the point, and that will be a stall coming out here from the side of Fnatic as he's on the point. Zizek is Fnatic. He's on the point. Going to be stalling it up. No, a flip. Another flip. Well, rip my voice, guys. We're going to be going back into a 99% contest here. If at any point the red team is not able to stand on the point, and they lose it. They will lose the match. They lose the Lucio. They have the Winston in the Primal Rage. Fan going up from Fnatic. He's barely going to go down. Amiz doesn't have that resurrection, so they won't have it quite up yet. He's running over. He did go down. Corazon trying to do what he can. He does have the pulse bomb. He's looking for Corazon. He does. No, he doesn't take him out. That resurrection is absolutely critical. We'll give the red team a fighting chance here, as they already lost one. Jazz picking up another one on Kotz. Amiz going to go down. Before he gets that resurrection, he actually fell off, guys. That's not what you want to see if you're a side of the Polis Overwatch team. Bernie on the point, trying to fight it out. Fragum as well. They're doing what they can. 11% on the point. Silence again with that Pharah. And again, guys, I apologize for the crazy camera work, but King of the Hill maps are so hard to keep everything that I want you guys to see. There's so many mini conflicts and clashes and skirmishes going on everywhere that it may get a little hectic on the camera work, and I apologize. I am trying to work on it and trying to get better so that you guys can have the best viewing experience possible. Here we go. Blue team pushing in right side. Jazz first with that barrier. Cubix with the sound barrier. Going to be picking up his team, giving them extra HP. All of the blue team is on the point at this time. Most of them 4-2. They're losing multiple. Bernie picks up one. Silence picks up one. But Fnatic and Cubix have answered so far. Two down for both sides. But critical, Amiz is down. Amiz is down again, guys. That's the critical thing to note here. God, Caduceo going to be picking up another one. Will he be carrying it for his team? That Graviton Surge. That Graviton Surge. Is it enough? They're going to clean up the Winston. They could flip the point here. There's no one on the side of the red team on the point. If they kill this hero, they will be able to flip it. They don't have anyone on the point right now because, or not enough players on the point. There's the Rocket Barrage. There's the swap. Will they get on the point? No. Shizek, Munipbo, Zhizhak, the Polish Overwatch team will take it, guys, in a 2-0 King of the Hill decider match. Wow. What a crazy match. We'll just go ahead and watch this amazing play of the game. Corazon, I know that he was playing a really strong Tracer player. It may just be, as most of you guys will say, a Q of the game, and no, he doesn't even have the ult. This is just good right clicks coming out of him. Good pursuit. He does line up. Look at him aiming for the head, switching his targets, staying at decent distance. Good Tracer play out of him. 49 kill participation, 70% kill participation. Amazing out of him. So Sazek, we'll go ahead and move on, guys. If I had the titles improper, I forgive me. But Serious Intentions will be dropping down into the loser's bracket. Again, thank you so much for tuning in and stopping by. If you have any criticisms for my casting, please let me know in the chat. Or if you have any pronunciations, if I'm messing up the names, origins, anything about these teams, please do let me know. I want to be right so that I can give you guys and these teams the best respect that they deserve. Thank you big time to Superstar League. Give them a follow for hosting this tournament, for putting up the prize pool, and also give them a follow on Twitter at Superstar Esports so that they can you guys can know about their next tournament when they post about it. Or any other information that they want to post on their Twitter. And lastly, casual plug, if you guys want to follow me, you can. Raptors Overwatch or Raptors OW on Twitter. But more so, follow the tournament. Follow these guys. They're the ones hosting it. They're the ones putting up the games. So thank you so much. And we'll be kicking it to some music and a waiting screen as I figure out the next game and give my voice a slight rest as we'll get into the third match of the day. And once again, guys, thank you so much for your patience, participation, and watching these games.